Hello, my little angels. Welcome to another edition of Headlines and Events, G20 Month Edition. That's right, we are 3 weeks away from the G20. I can hardly contain my excitement. This is actually the most exciting thing to happen to the country since former UN Secretary General Ban Ki-moon's plane was rerouted to Cordoba, and he stopped at an IPF for a cafecito and alfajor de maicena while driving to Buenos Aires. I'm not kidding you, that actually happened. Stars, they really are just like us. Speaking of exciting, you know who's slowly coming out of the shadows and thinking about re-election? That's right, President Macri. Because, you know, the fact that the country didn't burst into flames the last few months as we tried to navigate a freaking economic meltdown is in itself quite an accomplishment. Macri is feeling super emboldened by this and said that this week he intends to seek a second term in the presidential elections next year and that he is ready to continue if Argentines believe that this path of change is worth it. Is it worth it? Do we really want to go there? Do we want to talk about that? The president insisted that his plan is the only possible road to take. Cue Waze / GPS / Google Maps. I think there are many other roads that we could maybe go down, but hey, what do I know? And that Argentina cannot be based on lies and demagoguery in a not-so-thinly-veiled attack on Cristina Kirchner, his mortal nemesis. Hashtag frenemies. Now, this is all great and cool and fun, but it's been a really tough year for Argentines. I mean, obviously, understatement of the millennium, but we need to just sort of state the obvious at this point. We've seen an insane inflation rate, a horrible devaluation, a drop in productivity, and a shrinking economy. Shrinking. And because of this, the president's popularity has also suffered, because duh. And it continues to suffer, because obviously. According to a recent poll conducted by D'Alessio Irol Consulting, Macri's popularity has shrunk to 37%, the lowest it's been since he took office in 2015. Also, isn't 37 like our inflation rate? Cheeky. Just 1 year ago after the midterms, approval was at 53, so that's quite a drop. Do the math unless you didn't pay attention in school, like me. I actually can't add. I can't do long division. So sue me. Don't sue me. Better call Saul. At the same time, people still seem to rely on the Cambiemos coalition to turn things around. And while 40% of Cambiemos supporters believe next year is going to be worse than this one, worse? Actually, how is that possible? Prepare the Xanax. 57% remain optimistic and say that they are hoping for the storm to pass. So I guess not all is lost? Can we quit it with the storm metaphors? My hair is suffering from all this humidity. I need like a desert. Let's dry things out. And quite honestly, as long as an Argentine Bolsonaro or Trump doesn't win next year, I'll be happy. If I see just one more Make Argentina Great Again hat, I swear to freaking God I'm gonna lose it. Okay? Okay, let's just change the subject. This is making me anxious. Get the Xanax ready. Maybe a face mask, maybe some sound vibrations, a meditation room, just, okay. And last but not least, though I'm pretty sure you don't care at all, the Budget Commission in the Senate passed the 2019 budget bill this week and sent it on to the floor so it can be voted, hopefully, into law on November 14th. This way, it'll be ready before the G20 starts. The Cambiemos coalition needs at least 12 non-Cambiemos senators to vote in favor of it so it can have a total of 37 votes and pass it and make the IMF happy. I mean, if the Senate suddenly doesn't decide to pass it, to the boats, boys and girls, because this is going to be a huge disaster. Like, get those little life jackets, some oars, like a little hat. All right, let's just move on to events, because not all in life is politics. I mean, actually, it is, especially here, but that's something for another day. First of all, it's that time of year again. Temperatures are starting to rise, trees are beginning to show the first signs of blossom and pollen, and the pharmaceutical market is making a killing as anti-allergy tablets just fly off the shelves. The streets are filled with affordable and seasonable fruit and veg, and yet for some reason, we want to go to the supermarket, buy a genetically modified winter grapefruit, wait in line 20 minutes to pay for it, and then get home only to find that it's flavorless, dry, and a massive waste of time. But fear no more, because Buenos Aires is bringing you the latest edition of Mesa, seasonal menus with Argentine flavors. Mesa is a celebration of seasonality and a platform to teach, inspire, and promote nutritional and environmentally friendly lifestyles without breaking the bank. It's held all across Argentina, Mendoza, Rosario, Neuquén, and San Martín de los Andes, and every year it's getting bigger and bigger. So, from November 6th to 12th, chefs around the country will be experimenting with chickpeas, asparagus, strawberries, and blackberries, and some of the best of these restaurants are right in your backyard in Buenos Aires. So make sure you check out our website and book a table. Save me a seat. Order me a nice bottle of wine because I have expensive taste. But I also can be frugal. It's all about doing both. Little verse. And last but not least, Personal Fest is back. One of the biggest music festivals in Argentina. This year it's bringing some amazing artists like Robbie Williams, Lorde, Death Cab for Cutie, and more. Fun fact, my sister was truly obsessed with Robbie Williams in high school and maybe tried to find out where he lived. It starts this Saturday at 3 p.m. at the Club Ciudad de Buenos Aires, and pretty much everyone is planning on being there. Except for me, because I don't really care. But I won't judge you if you do, don't worry. Just stay away from the pogos. Those can get dangerous. Gotta watch the moneymaker. Gotta stay safe. All right, guys, that's all for now. I hope you have a big weekend, and if you get caught in the pogo, don't call me, because I warned you about it, and you chose to ignore me. I hate to say I told you so. No, I don't. I love it. Also, if you produce black clothing, please call me, because clearly I need a sponsor. I'm wearing the same t-shirt every week. Can you tell?